cool as much. Oh, and some more ice too. through the brain. No, she's one of the chicks, I think. I guess she's Jay. Well, you ain't this. Jay's crazy means that she goes for this. Just between you and me, I don't get it either, but I gotta listen. I love connoisseurs and music lovers. Me, I like Guy Lombardo. What's the matter with him? He's fucked. The music's driving him crazy. Come down, Jack. Convertible, wears a mink coat, and knows everybody, but she always comes in her own.
Yes.
May I?
Yes.
Yeah.
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 Yes, sir.
Just take a look. I don't even want to look at it.
Are you all right, sir?
Yes, sir. All right, I just had too big a night, I guess. There it is. Doctor's gonna
Thank you. Thank you.
Are you a friend of my brother's?
I never met him.
before he called me yesterday, didn't he?
Why didn't you ask Mr. Holliday?
Obviously, Mr. Holliday wasn't here yesterday. Or he wouldn't have had a line from you that Phillips called. You're the logical person to know who else Phillips called.
I don't believe that's any of your business, Mr.
Don't think you're dealing with anything confidential, Miss Foster. I know that he tried to reach somebody else. Mrs. Phillips told you.
No,
definitely.
I don't know what you're after, but you're trying to kick me. Mrs. Phillips, didn't tell you a thing.
What do you mean?
She
doesn't. Why wouldn't she? Wait a minute. I was talking about George Reynolds. Who did you think I meant, Jets? Who is it that Mrs. Phillips doesn't know about?
I told you before that. None of your business.
All right, young lady. I'm going to give you a straight Phillips' word.
What? What do you mean?
She told me because he needed me to clear him. Phillips is innocent. Innocent men don't have to jump out of windows. Just who are you trying to protect, Miss Foster? Why are you so afraid to tell the truth?
I'm not protecting anyone.
All right, young listen to me. This thing is going to explode wide open. You got nothing to hide, you better start talking. Or maybe you are, Mr.
No!
Well, then come on.
She wants to see Molly. She wants to see you yesterday.
Who's Molly?
She's a model. She and Mr. Phillips used to be quite friendly, but we haven't been seen for quite some time.
Come on.
The last couple of months, he's been trying to locate her and find out where she lived yesterday morning. When he returned from seeing her, he was terribly upset. But that's when he had me put in the calls for you. We couldn't reach you even at home. The last time I saw him, he was. I don't think Mr. Phillips realized I was aware of this friendship with Marla Cudillo. Out of respect for him, I never intended to tell anything. I had no idea that she had anything to do with the trouble he was in.
Well, my discretion is best. You know, you must be pretty friendly with Stanley, Miss Foster. You knew how desperately his brother tried to reach me yesterday, and he wasn't even there at the time. And now you seem to know all about what happened to Mrs. Phillips.
Understand, we usually don't give out information about our clients.
I know you're a couple of high-class fellows, but revealing anything confidential is against the ethics of our establishment.
That's right, honesty is the best policy.
But in your case, here's Mr. Your personal friend, Mr. Dunlop.
Thanks, I know you've come through.
There it is. We don't have his address. He must have called for the picture. But he shouldn't have been able to prove it, sir. Of course, his name is not Charles Jones. It isn't. Well, what is it? It's a huh? Oh.
It's Raymond Rakubi.
Rakubi? What's the news about that? Just how you raised it.
Thank you. soft in the bed.
You do that again and I'll kick you in the face. Lay off, just cut it off.
Shut up! Who asked you?
I just told you, I'm looking for Lena Rakubi.
Did I get you?